to look in the camera and tell people, and we'll start with you, Martha, and go right down the line.
My name's Martha Dean, and I'm running for governor because I've heard loud and clear from the people of Connecticut that they are overtaxed, the state spends too much, the state infringes on their private sphere and on their constitutional rights too much. My background is I'm an attorney. As I said earlier, I litigate my values. I've litigated the budget cap in Connecticut or the for the Roger Sherman Liberty Center. I'm litigating against public sector unions currently for the National Right to Work Foundation, although I agree with private sector unions. I think they serve a valuable purpose, and we should honor our commitments to public sector union employees. I also am litigating the case on behalf of the group that's challenging the new post-Newtown firearms law. It is critical that we stop our state from infringing on Second Amendment rights. So as your governor, I pledge to end the income tax overtime, to end public sector unions while honoring current employees, to bring in, to make sure that government does what it's supposed to do and nothing more, and that it stops infringing on core rights and interfering in citizens' lives. Thank you very much.
Marty, thanks for doing this. We really appreciate you giving us a few moments. It's always a pleasure, and I'll be back. Ladies and gentlemen, I just want to thank you for watching tonight. I'm really excited about Connecticut's future, and I certainly believe that there is a better day coming for all of us. There are certain things that we need to do to ensure that the taxpayers and residents of this state feel that they're back engaged and they're back in the game, if you will. I've been very clear during this campaign saying that we ought to cut the gas tax because I believe you pay too much for taxes. We need to come up with a better regulatory plan as it relates to our utilities because you pay too much for electricity. I believe we need to lower our business taxes so all of our businesses will be on the same plan. And I believe we need a homestead property exemption for our seniors so that we can keep them in their homes and allow them to age in place. These are simple proposals, but I think will make a profound difference in the ability of our state and our businesses and our companies to put people back to work. And at the end of the day, we'll be able to generate more tax revenue. We'll be able to have a more vibrant economy if we're able to put people back to work. So I appreciate your time tonight. You can learn more about me at teambouton.com. Marty, we're having a sale tonight on good government.
Great.
Just $100, and away we go.
Joe, you have the final word.
Marty, thanks for having us. Martha, thanks for being here. Mark, thanks for being here. It's really a pleasure. Folks, I'm not taking citizens' election money. I don't believe in taking taxpayers' money, but I think everyone that does it. Please go to my website and donate anything you can afford. Have a tax sale for me, ViscontiForGovernor.com. We just went national with a viral video, and I'm looking to nationalize this race on the Second Amendment, which I oppose SB 1160. All the details on all the programs where I stand are on my website, ViscontiForGovernor.com. Thank you all for watching. Hold on, Republican governor's on its way, and it's going to be me.
Thanks a lot. Thank you very much. I want to thank the candidates. Thanks for us. We'll see you next week. I have no idea what we're doing next week, but that's why I got 6 days to figure it out. Thanks for joining us, and vote for one of these guys. I think they're great. Good night.